Now in activity 5, what problems? So the first what problem? First we have to read the question, then understand. See here, Raju and Peter bought a large pizza to share. So then Raju ate 5/8 of a pizza. What fraction of the pizza was left for Peter? So here total, so one pizza they bought. In that one pizza, so 5/8 fraction, who ate? Raju ate. Then how much pizza was left for Peter? She is asking. Then first what we have to do? So how much portion Raju ate? So Raju ate 5/8 of pizza. So this portion he ate. Then what fraction of the pizza was left for Peter? So what we have to find? So what fraction means in total one pizza. So we have to subtract this 5/8. Then whatever the difference will come, so that much portion is left for Peter. Here we have to subtract. From whole pizza, from complete pizza, we have to subtract this 5/8. Then fraction of pizza left for Peter. So in complete one pizza, so we have to subtract 5/8. There is no by means, by one. So how to subtract? So we have to multiply these denominators. 1 8 is 8. After that we have to cross multiply. First fraction numerator with second fraction denominator. 1 8 is 8. Then after that minus sign. First fraction denominator with second fraction numerator. 1 5 is 5. 8 minus 5, 3/8. 3/8 fraction is left. 3/8 fraction of the pizza is left for Peter. Okay. In this way we have to find. Okay. Now the second one, Miss Blooms baked a cake. She ate 1/12 of a cake and gave 7/12 of the cake to her neighbor. So what fraction of the cake was left here? So how much fraction of the cake she ate? 1/12. And how much fraction of the cake she gave to her neighbor? 7/12. First, how much ate and how much she gave? That two portions we have to add. So after adding that two portion, so in the complete one cake, that two we have to subtract. Then whatever the difference will come, so that much fraction of the portion, so fraction of the cake was left. Okay. First, fraction of the cake. Fraction of the cake she ate. How much? 1/12. Cake, fraction of the cake she gave. She gave to neighbor. That is 7/12. So this much she gave. Then total fraction of the cake, total fraction of the cake she ate and gave to neighbor. So we have to add 1/12 plus 7/12. These two are like fractions, direct we have to add numerators. 1 plus 7, 8. 8 by 12. Then fraction of the cake left. fraction of the cake left is equal to, in total one cake we have to subtract 8/12. There is no by means, by one we have to take. Now what to do? So we have to multiply this denominator, 1 12 is 12. Then after that what we have to do? First fraction numerator with second fraction denominator we have to multiply, 1 12 is 12. Then first fraction denominator with second fraction numerator, 1 8 is 8, minus 8, 12 minus 8, 4, 4 by 12, 4 by 12. So this have common factor, 4, 4 1s are, 4 3s are, that is 1 by 3. This fraction of the cake left, 1 by 3 fraction of the cake left. First what we have to do, so we have to find, so the total fraction of the cake she ate and she gave to neighbor. So after adding, so that addition, that sum we have to subtract from whole cake, in complete cake. Then what fraction of the cake left we got. Then in the third question, Monica and Rayan shared 18 cookies. Monica ate 1/6 of the cookies and Rayan ate 1/3 of the cookies. How many cookies were left? So first we have to find, so this how many she ate, how many he ate, first we have to find. In the total cookies that we have to subtract. So first, number of cookies, number of number of is Monica ate. Monica, that is 1/6 portion, 1/6 into total 18 cookies. There is no by means, by one is there. Then 1 into 18 by 6 into 1. So these two have common factor, then cancel with 6. 6 1s are 6 3s are, then 1 3s are 3 by 1 1s are 1, then 3 by 1 is 3. 3 cookies she ate. Who? Monica. Then number of cookies, Rayan ate. So that is 1/3. 1/3 into 18. 18 by 1. Then 1 into 18. 3 into 1. Then these 3 cancel in 3 table. 3 1s are 3 6s are. Then 1 6s are 6 by 1. 6 by 1 6 cookies. 6 cookies she ate. He ate. Then total cookies both 8. Both 8 is equal to 3 plus 6 is equal to 9. 9 cookies they ate. So 3 cookies she ate, Monica, and 6 cookies he ate, Rayan. Then both how many cookies they ate? 3 plus 6 9 cookies they ate. Then how many cookies left? Number of cookies left. In total cookies, so we have to subtract 9 cookies. 18 minus 9, 9 cookies left. So this many cookies left. Okay, this is the procedure. Okay, okay students. Now the next word problem, see here, fourth. You go out for a long walk. You walked 3/4 meals. This many meals. And after that sit down and take rest, and then you walk 3/8 meals. So this many miles here, first 3/4 miles. How many miles are there? 3/4 miles. So you traveled by walk. And after that what you did? You sit down. So and after that again you take rest. And again then you start your walking. And after that 3/8 miles you walked. So 3/8 miles you walked. So before how many miles you walked? 3/4 miles you walked. And after that, after rest, again you walked 3/8 miles. So then how far did you walk all together? All together means total, he is asking. Total means we have to add. So before rest, then after rest. So the total distance we have to add, then you will get all together how much distance you walked, how many miles you covered, that you will get. Okay, then here the solution, distance covered before rest, how much? 3/4 miles. 3/4, this many miles covered. So then distance covered after rest, how much distance? 3/8 miles. 3/8 miles. Then total distance covered means 3/4 plus 3/8. So 3/4 and 3/8. So now how to add by taking LCM? 4 and 8 LCM, denominator LCM. 4 is a factor of 8. So if one of a number is factor of the other, the bigger number is the LCM. 8 is the LCM. In 4 table, when you'll get 8, 2 za, so multiply with 2. In 8 table, when you'll get 8, 1 za, 3 2 za 6, plus 3 1 za 3. That is 6 plus 3, 9. 9 by 8 miles. 9 by 8. 9 by 8 miles means 1/8 miles in mixed fraction. This many miles you covered. So before and after, all together how much distance you covered? 1/8 miles you covered. Okay. Now, the next question, a school wants to make a new playground by cleaning up and abandoned a lot that is shaped like a rectangle. They give a job of planning the playground to a group of students. So here a school wants to make a playground for students. So this that is in a rectangular shape. So that complete playground is in the shape of rectangle, and they give the job to the students. So they are cleaning and all that things they are doing, students, and they are planning. They also planned. So what they planned, the student decide. They decide that 1/4 of the playground for basketball. They planned and they decide that, so in that complete area, in that whatever area is their playground area, in that 1/4 playground, so they decide for basketball ground. They want to prepare basketball court. And after that, 3/8 of the playground, so for a snooker. This is 3/8 of the playground is soccer. So 3/8 of the playground for soccer. So 1/4. So this 1/4 of the playground is for basketball and 3/8 of the playground for soccer. So then how much is left using for swings and play equipments? So if they decide 1/4 of the playground for basketball and 3/8 of the playground for soccer, then how much area of the playground is left? How much playground area is left for the equipments, swings and play equipments, other equipments? So how much area is left, he is asking. First, what we have to do here? First, we have to find how much area they decide for basketball as well as soccer. So we have to add both. So 1/4 and 3/8. So after addition, so after adding, we will get how much area already completed for this basketball court and soccer field. So then in complete ground, we consider as 1. In that 1, so we have to minus this sum. Then you'll get how much area is left for swings and other play equipments. Okay. Now here, playground area decide for basketball court got 1/4 area. 1/4 area they decided. 1/4 area decided. So this much area they decide. So for what? So for basketball. Okay. Now area decide. Decide for soccer. 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 Soccer field. How much area they decided? 3/8. So area decided for basketball court 1/4. Area decided for soccer field 3/8. Then area decided. Decide for basketball. Basketball court and soccer field. We have to add 1/4 plus 3/8. Then, so 4 and 8 LCM is 8. In 4 table, when you'll get 8 2s, multiply with 2. In 8 table, when you'll get 8 1s, multiply with 1. 1 2s are 2, 3 1s are 3. That is 5/8. 5/8 portion is over already. Then area left for swings and other play equipments. One minus this complete 5/8 we have to take. Now LCM is 8. In one table when you get 8 8s. In 8 table 1s. 1 8s 8 minus 5. 8 minus 5 3. 3/8. This much portion is left. This much fraction of the portion is left for so the swings and other play equipments. Okay. Now 6th question. So you have 10 cookies and want to give half of them to a friend. How many do you give to your friend? So total how many cookies are given? 10 cookies were given. In this 10 cookies you want to give half of them to your friend. So then it means how many cookies you gave to your friend. So total how many cookies were there? 10 cookies were there. In that 10 cookies half means 1/2 means half. 1/2 means half. Half of the cookies you gave to your friend. Half means 10 half. We know 10 half is 5. Direct. This is a direct question. So half of the cookies gave to your friend. Then he is asking how many cookies you gave to your friend. So then how to find? Half of. Half means multiplication sign we have to use. So then total cookies. Total 10. Cookies give to your friend. Is half of this means half of 10. Half 1/2. Half means into 10. 10 means by 1. We have to multiply numerator with numerator. 1 into 10 by 2 into 1. So these two have common factor 2, so multiply with, cancel with 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10. So then what is there in the numerator? 1 into 5 is 5, 1 1s are 1, 5 by 1 is 5, 5 cookies. This many cookies you gave to your friend. So 10 half means 5, 10 half means 5, 5 cookies you gave to your friend. Okay. Now. So 5 friends buy a package of 12 cookies and want to share them equally. So total how many friends were there? 5 friends. So these 5 friends purchase by 12 cookies. How many cookies they purchased? 12 cookies they purchased and they want to share equally. So they are sharing equally. So each will get 1/5 of the cookies. So 5 friends were there. If so they shared equally means 1/5, 1/5, 1/5, each will get 1/5 only. So then if they get equally 1/5 of the cookies, then how many will each friend will get? How many each friend will get? He is asking. First, how many cookies are there? First we have to check 12 cookies. In that 12 cookies, so each friend will get 1/5 means. So we have to 1/5 of 12 we have to find. 1/5 of 12. So each will get 1/5 of 12. So then we have to find 1/5 of 12 is how much? That much they will get. Okay. Then total cookies. Each will get 1/5 of cookies. That means 1/5 of cookies. How many cookies? 12. That means 1/5 of means multiplication 12. There is no by means by 1. Now we have to multiply. There is no common factor. We have to multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator. 1 12 is a 12, 5 1s are 5. 12 by 5 cookies each will get. Okay.